Hello and welcome to the Daily Transcript Newsroom. Coming up in local events, ComNexus makes lemonade out of lemons with its panel discussion Monday on why now is the best time to be an entrepreneur, featuring local celebrity Sam the Cooking Guy. And on Tuesday, the group examines how to turn ideas into money with Daily Transcript technology correspondent and author Phil Baker. The first North American Building Integrated Photovoltaics business meeting kicks off Monday in San Diego and runs through Wednesday. The San Diego Software Industry Council hones in on Twitter as a business tool at its Friday program. And also Friday, Denver District Attorney Mitch Morrissey comes to town to chat with City Club of San Diego and nonprofit Lead San Diego about the use of DNA in solving crime cases. Nationally this week, the Federal Reserve releases consumer credit data for February and minutes from its March meeting. Retailers report sales results. The Labor Department releases weekly jobless claims. The Commerce Department releases international trade for February and wholesale trade inventories for February. Freddie Mac releases weekly mortgage rates, and the Treasury releases the federal budget for March. Markets are closed on Friday in observance of Good Friday. In earnings news, local companies WD-40 and Cardiodynamics are releasing results. In this week's close-up, Donald Whitaker, Bill Whitaker, and Glenn Stewart talk about how they've made D.A. Whitaker Construction into one of San Diego's leading companies. In real estate news, San Diego County's apartment vacancy rate in March topped 5% for the first time since the mid-1990s, according to a survey by MarketPoint Realty Advisors. With more doubling up and young adults returning home, the apartment vacancy climbed to an average of 5.29%, the biannual survey stated. And George Chamberlain writes about the California Public Employees Retirement System's focus list and how it has given CalPERS influence in the investing world. The focus list is a group of companies that are part of the fund's investment portfolio and are chronic underperformers with subpar governance practices. For more on our stories, check out the links below. I'm Elizabeth Malloy, and thanks for clicking.